Would you like to learn how to run Doom and Jam on your own machine? So stay with me and I'm gonna replicate the steps that Gavin Wood showed a few months ago in a presentation. It's really simple. You can go to this URL. Basically, you have to search for Polkadot Jam releases on GitHub under the Parity Tech organization, and then you go to releases. And then you need to download the latest one. The one that I'm trying to do here is the 0.1.27. I am using a macOS version because, well, I have this one, but you can try the other versions. So basically, after you download this file, you will have these contents. Let me share you with you the contents. So these are the contents inside this tar file. And inside it, there is a file that you can read and follow the steps, the CoreVM readme. So I'm gonna read it. And if you are a macOS user, you need to install these two libraries, the SDL2 and SDL2TTF. And in Ubuntu, you have to install this one. Yes. And then you need to export the library dir to make it available to execute it. And then you just run these commands over here. Very, very simple. So first of all, you will run the gem test, the PolkaJam or the gem network testnet. Basically, this command will start a local chain with 6 nodes. So we called it a tiny chain. So a tiny chain with 6 nodes, basically, this is what is running here. And the blockchain is already running, generating blocks, creating blocks, and validating each node, validating each other's blocks. So finalizing and everything else. Okay, now that the chain is running, we need to deploy the service. So the command to deploy service is gemt. So gemt is the other command that I'm going to run over here. And basically, it will look for a binary. The binary is the Doom CoreVM, which is the service that we are deploying in our gem chain. So we'll create this, the gemt command, just for you to give a little bit of example, is a interface that talks with the networks, with the local network, and send information. It's similar to sending transactions on an ordinary blockchain through RPC calls. So basically this command will try to, you have other commands that you can do like transfers or inspect, queue, pack, all this stuff. But in this case, we'll simply create a new service using this command here. And you see there are all the outputs here. Oops, let me do it again. So it's creating a work package to submit it. And this work package is responsible for executing the work of creating a service. And then the service ID, this is the service ID. So the service was created and its ID is this one. So what I need to do now is to run this other command over here, which is the CoreVM builder. So once the service is there, means the code is deployed. Now we need to interact with that code. Basically, building new packages, sending these packages to this service to execute the service from external information. So it would be similar to interacting with a smart contract. So the first step created the service, which would be similar to deploy a smart contract. And the second step is continuously sending new transactions or new information and executing functions inside the smart contracts, or in this case, in Jam, the service. So basically, this command is not correct. Basically, you just need to do this, CoreVM builder, and then the service ID. This doc is not correct. You don't need all these things. You just need this. Oops, sorry. CoreVM builder, and then the ID, and that's it. All you need is this. Now you just need to monitor, and then let me run it here, and it will open a new window, and this window will, it's here, here we go. Doom is already running on my gem. So what is happening here? Basically, the chain is executing the work packages and everything. So everything is being executed here on the blockchain. This process is responsible for keep sending new packages, means continue the execution, send the new information so the execution can continue on the blockchain. And this process here basically is reading the output. This process that is being executed, the service that we deployed, is saving data on the gem data availability, which means that the execution of the service stores some data, and this data in this case is the output of the display. So there is a display device or virtual device that every new frame that the display receives from the game is being saved somewhere into this data availability. And this process here basically reads from this data availability layer and prints to us the frames so we can see. This is not a video being played. This is the actual code of the game. The original Doom code was compiled to PVM, which is the virtual machine that is inside Gem, and it's being executed as it is. And the output of the game, in this case, there is a display. The video that the game is playing is being recorded into this data availability, and then we can read from it. So we can have this virtual monitor where we can see what is being displayed in, would be displayed in the real game. Okay, so this is very simple. Three steps: run the node, step one. Step two, deploy the service. Step three, create the builder process to execute the service that was deployed. And step four, look at the results into a virtual monitor. And then you have Doom running on your chain. If you want to replicate this on your machine, you are very welcome. If you have any comments, or if you can do it, please comment in this video so we can know how many people, if you have any problems or if you have any doubts, just let us know and we're gonna evolve this, trying to deploy other services and create other tutorials so you can start enjoying the gem chain, which testnet is being developed, about to be released soon. And we are starting to play with the potential services that we can run on top of this chain. I hope you enjoyed the video. Thanks for watching.